down there with her. Sophie's husband Richard is there, and her five sons, Sonny, Kit, Ray, Jesse, and Mickey, and her mum, Janet, wonderful Janet Ellis, who we love from Blue Peter. There's tears, unsurprisingly. Oh, kids, I have to say, if you can hear me, Sonny, Kit, Ray, Jesse, and Mickey, how brilliant is your mummy? They're all dancing now. Oh, bless you. Richard, let's hear from you, Richard, darling. You've been with Sophie all night.
Oh, Jesse, yeah.
Which was the toughest bit for you, Richard? He's going to mime his answer because he doesn't have a microphone.
That's my favourite.
Hang on. He comes to the microphone.
I feel completely deranged. But Sophie's been unbelievable. I can't believe what she's done here, the stamina, and she's still going, and all I've done is just been trying to support her.
And make cups of tea.
Yeah, there's a lot of cups of tea and a lot of silly dance moves. We vogued at about 4 a.m. and with me wearing a horse's head, which I think helps.
It's an amazing moment. Richard, if you wouldn't mind taking the microphone over to Janet.
She has one.
Sophie's mum. Janet, good morning, my darling. How has this been for you to watch your girl just being so super wonderful and just, she's been astounding.
Amazing. But you know what it made me think of? When Sophie was younger and still living at home and would go out for the evening, and I would keep checking on her room to see if she was back, and she wasn't. This time, I knew where she was, but it still made me feel nervous.
I don't think that ever goes. Okay, go. Sophie's wonderful family, she's surrounded by Richard and her mum, Janet, and all her kids. Let's have another totalizer. Radio 2 listeners, you have just been so wonderful. Sorry, I'm teary now, seeing Sophie with her family. So the total raised so far by you wonderful Radio 2 listeners from Sophie Ellis-Bextor's Kitchen Disco Dance-a-thon is, just you wait for it,
seven hundred and eleven thousand nine hundred and
the Louise in Wimbledon sent a beautiful message. My 18-year-old son, Joe, has had so many operations in his life, faced them with courage, determination, and resilience. Without children in need, the support for our young people would be depleted. And it's up to us to invest in the future. So donate, everyone. Sophie, your inspiration. Louise in Wimbledon, thank you for your message. If you want to donate £10, text the word GIVE, G-I-V-E, to 70410. To donate £20, text the word GIVE, G-I-V-E, to 70420. You can donate any amount by heading to the Radio 2 website. You can do that now. It's time to pause for thought. And we're joined this morning by Laura Marks. Good morning, Laura.
Good morning. How is your morning going on there?
What an incredible force of nature Sophie Ellis-Bextor is. She's wonderful, Laura. What do you have for us this morning?
So I'm in total awestruck admiration as Sophie nears the end of her day-long dancing marathon. Last weekend, my feet were aching, my back sore, and my head throbbing as I sang along tunelessly to a karaoke version of I'd Like to Teach the World to Sing. And that was after only 10 minutes. I wasn't alone. I share this uncoordinated disco fiasco, so different from Sophie's, with 50 Muslim and Jewish women who held hands, totally abandoning inhibition, doing the female equivalent of dad dancing. The dancing rounded off 24 hours cooped up together in London's historic East End, immersed in the culture, prayer spaces and food, as well as the concerns and fears of our Jewish and Muslim sisters. We visited a mosque which had been a synagogue formerly a church, and a church which survived the 1666 Fire of London but was bombed in the turbulent 1990s. We ate curry, made cards for welcome refugees, and cried, but also chuckled about inequalities facing women. In small groups, we had challenging conversations, and some women, not me of course, even managed an early morning run. Most importantly, we connected and helped build bridges between An-Nisa, the Arabic word for women, and An-Nashim, the Hebrew equivalent. I came home with a deep pink cotton friendship thread tied to my wrist by my Muslim friend and sister Hifsa, perfectly matching my nails. 24 hours is just one day, but it can change the world. The money Sophie's raised today would change children's lives forever. With my weekend bag packed, new friends' addresses carefully stored, and my phone switched back on, I reflected on how much good can be done in a day before returning home to the untouched Washing Up Mountain of just one day.
Thank you so much, Laura, for sharing with us this morning, my darling. Here's Richie. Winky travel.
Thanks, Paul. We're still on the M62 westbound, which is queuing between 27 and 26. That's because of an accident. M60 anti-clockwise queuing at 2 at the moment for Stockport Road. There was an accident earlier on. We're also seeing delays because of this, heading on the M56 towards Manchester. Clockwise is slow at the moment, just after 16 for Pendlebury because of an accident. On the M40 south, it's partially blocked between 5 and 4 for High Wycombe. That's because of an accident. M1 south is heavy between 23A and 23 for Loughborough. That's because of an accident. M25 anti-clockwise. We've got a lane blocked on the exit slip road to the junction at junction 21A for St Albans. That's because of an accident. On the M23 Gatwick Spur Road, got one lane closed between junction 9 and junction 9A, and that's because of a broken down car. I'll have more in 25 minutes. Keep going, Sophie.
Oh, Richie, she's got 6 minutes to go. Can I just say thank you so much to Ezekiel for talking to us today, to Brad, Ellie and Mason's dad, to Sam, mum to Leah and Abby, and everybody affected by so many challenges. All the money you wonderful listeners have helped to raise this morning, this 24 hours with Sophie, will do so much good. 6 minutes to go. Let's join Sophie back down in the Radio Theatre for one final sing-along. I can't believe she's singing after all of this. Amazing.
Thank you.
24 hours. She is just something, isn't she? Incredible scenes at the Radio Theatre right now. Richard, husband to Sophie, has joined on guitar. I think he has a dog's hat on, looking amazing. Wow. The kids are dancing around the stage. Janet's dancing as well. Let's sing along with our dancing queen with 3.5 minutes to go. Sophie, you've done it, my darling. You are amazing, Sophie. You've danced for 24 hours. You've raised so much money. Sophie, how do you feel that you've completed it?
Oh, this has been extraordinary. Hang on a minute, Mick May. No, I always thought this would be an amazing privilege to have done, and I've never done anything like this. I want to thank everybody for giving me the opportunity. And I've been weepy, like, solidly for the last hour. And this has been really special. I thank you to everybody who donated, and everybody who gave me energy and support and messages. It's got me through.
Sophie, honestly, thank you so much to all the team from Children in Need and BBC who've supported Sophie. Thank you to Professor Greg White as well. And thank you to Richard, with his Millennium Falcon guitar there. He's been so, I mean, gosh, what an amazing marriage you two have. You're amazing. Your kids, she's got to be a mum again now. So come on then. Let's do a final total during our show, but of course the money can keep coming in. Radio 2 listeners, Sophie Ellis-Begster. The total raised so far from Sophie's Kitchen Disco Dance-a-thon is quite something. 803,384 pounds, Sophie!
That's phenomenal. Thank you so much.
It is phenomenal. You are an incredible lady, Sophie. We love you so much. We're going to dance for you now because we think you deserve a nice glass of champagne or a cup of tea and a sit down. Let's play Cool and the Gang. Sophie Ellis-Begster, we love you so much.
Thank you.
On behalf of all those projects supported by Children in Need and all the families and the children supported by them, thank you, Sophie. You're amazing.
It's been an honour. It's actually really fun. Except that it's the world for them.
She's still standing. Let her sit down. Bring her cup of tea.
Am I allowed to not dance if people are talking to me now?
You don't have to dance anymore, Sophie. We love you.
It's been really amazing and actually quite fun.